This is the third video in our process costing series, where we'll be looking at the creation of a scuba mask. And our scuba masks are actually going to go through two different processes. The first process being the shaping process, which we'll actually focus most of our time on. And then we'll transfer to the second department, which is the insertion process. And this particular video is going to focus on the first process, which is the shaping process. So just like we discussed earlier, each process has materials, labor, and overhead that would be applied to the process, where we'll eventually have a shaped mask as our outcome. So for this particular process in our shaping department, we can draw our timeline here like we did before. We find that conversion cost, as we anticipate, are added evenly throughout the production process. Direct materials in this department are added at the beginning of the process. We also find that 40,000 masks have been completed and transferred out by the end of the period. They're 100% complete. And they're moved to the next process. However, 10,000 masks were started but not completed. So they remain an ending work in process in our shaping department, or our shaping process. And they are 25% complete. So step one in the process costing scenario is we have to summarize the flow of physical units. So the first thing in this step is to total our physical units to account for. How many individual units were worked on, completed or not? And then we have to show how we accounted for them. What happened to those products? Are they finished and transferred out, or are they still in our work in process inventory? So if we look at our spreadsheet here, we find our flow of physical units. The units that we need to account for, we had none in beginning inventory. Then we started in production 50,000 units. So we need to be able to account for 50,000 units, 50,000 masks. So the way we accounted for them is we completed and transferred out 40,000 masks. 40,000 were completed and transferred out during the period. Plus, we still had 10,000 masks in ending work in process that were not yet completed. So 40,000 plus 10,000 gives me my 50,000 masks that I have now completely accounted for. Step two in the process is to compute the output in terms of equivalent units. So again, I've given us our timeline here. Remember, conversion costs are added evenly throughout the process. Direct materials are added at the beginning of the process. 40,000 are completed and transferred out, so they're gone. But we still have 10,000 left in ending work in process. So we need to compute equivalent units for what we have completed and transferred out, as well as what's still in work in process. So if a unit has been completed and transferred out, it is 100% complete as to materials and conversion. So those 40,000 units that were complete and transferred out are all equivalent units because they are completed units. As for the 10,000 that are left in ending work in process, however, they are only 25% complete as to conversion cost, but they are 100% complete as to direct materials because direct materials were added at the beginning of the process. So we can see under our direct materials column there, 40,000 that were transferred out are all complete as to materials and all complete as to conversion. But what's left in ending, the 10,000 units in ending work in process, is 100% complete as to direct materials. So we have 10,000 equivalent units as to materials, but only 25% of that was completed as to conversion. So equivalent units as to conversion is only 2,500, 25% times 10,000. So we have 50,000 equivalent units as to direct materials, and we have 42,500 equivalent units as to conversion cost. Now, what if, instead of direct materials being added at the beginning of the process, what if direct materials were added at the end of the process? How would that change your computation of direct materials? So I'd like for you to think about that for a second, and then we'll go over it. So push pause on your player, and then we'll look at the answer. So in this situation, if direct materials are added at the end of the process, then we only have 40,000 units completed as to materials. So only 40,000 equivalent units as to materials. because those 10,000 that are still in work in process haven't gotten to the point where direct materials are added. So none of them are complete as to materials. And we still have 2,500 that are complete as to conversion. So we'd have 40,000 units completed as to materials and 42,500 units completed as to conversion. Let's look at a quick example. The frying department of Crinkle Chips had 110,000 partially completed units in work in process at the end of March. All of the direct materials had been added to these units, but the units were only 68% of the way through the conversion process. In addition, 1.2 million units had been completed and transferred out of the frying department to the packaging department during the month. How many equivalent units of direct materials and equivalent units of conversion costs are associated with the 1.2 million units completed and transferred out? The second part, compute the equivalent units of direct materials and the equivalent units of conversion cost associated with the 110,000 partially completed units still in ending work in process. And three, what are the total equivalent units of direct materials and the total equivalent units of conversion cost for the month? So I'd like for you to give this a shot and then we'll take a look at it. So we need to set up our spreadsheet to where we have our units accounted for. We have 1.2 million units that are completed and transferred out. And we still have 110,000 units that is still in work in process that are 68% of the way through the conversion process. So total units that we've accounted for are 1,310,000 units. If we compute the equivalent units for direct materials and conversion, we first find that all of the materials have been added to these units. So that must mean they were added at some point in the process prior to being 68% of the way through. So all of them are completed as to materials. And 68% are completed as to conversion cost. So the ones that are completed and transferred out are all equivalent units because they're completely through the process. The ending work in process is the one we really have to worry about. They are 100% complete as to direct materials, the entire 110,000. However, 68% through the conversion process. So 68% of 110,000 units is 74,800. So to compute the total equivalent units for materials is 1,310,000, and total equivalent units as to conversion would be 1,274,800.